Hello everyone, welcome to Elobrace. In this video, I will show you how to get files in a folder.
Go to UiPath Studio, create a new process, name the process name as files in folder. Provide the description as this process demo is about how to get files in a folder. Then click OK. Click on the main workflow on the designer panel. Drag and drop the new sequence and name the sequence. Drag and drop select folder activity. The select folder activity is opens a dialog window where you can choose a folder. Go to the property panel. In the selected folder field, press Ctrl K to create a variable. Then type the variable name as select folder path. Then click enter. The variable select folder path is stored with the complete path of the selected folder. Click OK. Drag and drop assign activity and name the activity. Go to variable panel, create a variable name as files. We are storing multiple files into a variable, so that use array variable type. Select array of string. Go to property panel. In the to field, call the variable files which you created for storing file list and click OK. In the value field, type directory.getFiles, then add an open bracket, then call the folder path variable, select folder path, then add and close bracket. The meaning of var directory is a folder. Unix, Linux uses the term directory. Windows uses the term folder. Let's say we are going to get the files from a folder. We return the function directory.getFiles. Here you can provide the direct folder path within double quotes instead of passing the variable. I hope this will help you to remember the function. Now click OK. Drag and drop for each activity to the designer panel. Go to the property panel. In the value field, call the variable files, then click OK. In the type argument, select string. Here we have the name item. Also, you can rename the default name. I will rename it as file according to my process flow. Drag and drop right line activity to the designer panel. and call the variable file. Now everything is ready. Go and execute the process. The automation is executing. Note that the output panel displays all the file names one by one, indicated in the write line activity. The purpose of this tutorial is, from here you can take your process to a different logical level. For example, you can segregate the files based on the file type like XLSX, PDF, text or CSV and so on. Or you can split the pages from each document, or you can open and extract details from each document, or you can measure the each file size, or you can rename each file, and so on. Thank you for watching. Connect with us for more tutorials.